Welcome. Exact and precise learning. Probability. Chances. So let's start with this. Random experiment. What is a random experiment? Definition. An experiment is called random experiment if it satisfies the following two conditions. It has more than one possible outcome. A possible result of an experiment is called its outcome. So it has more than one possible outcome. It is not possible to predict the outcome in advance. हम पहले से नहीं बता सकते, प्रेडिक्ट कर सकते कि आउटकम क्या आएगा. सो दैट्स अ डेफिनेशन ऑफ रैंडम एक्सपेरिमेंट. सो टॉसिंग ऑफ ए फेयर कॉइन इज एन रैंडम एक्सपेरिमेंट. इट हैज मोर देन वन पॉसिबल आउटकम, हेड और टेल, कंडीशन वन सेटिस्फाइड. एंड इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू प्रेडिक्ट द आउटकम इन एडवांस कि हेड आएगा या टेल आएगा. पहले से नहीं बता सकते जब हम एक कॉइन को टॉस कर रहे हैं. सो इट्स ए रैंडम एक्सपेरिमेंट, टॉसिंग ऑफ ए फेयर कॉइन. ड्रॉइंग ए कार्ड फ्रॉम ए वेल शफल्ड पैक ऑफ कार्ड्स इज अ रैंडम एक्सपेरिमेंट एज इट हैज मोर देन वन पॉसिबल आउटकम. इफ यू ड्रॉ वन कार्ड, 52 कार्ड्स हैं, तो दे आर 52 पॉसिबल आउटकम्स. And it is not possible to predict the outcome in advance. हमने एक कार्ड ड्रॉ किया, हम पहले से नहीं प्रेडिक्ट कर सकते कि कौन सा कार्ड आएगा. Random experiment. Another term, sample space. What is the definition? The set of all possible outcomes. This term is important. All possible outcomes, not different outcomes, all possible outcomes. In permutation combination, we check about the all distinct outcomes, number of distinct outcomes. Here, number of all possible outcomes. So I'll read it again. The set of all possible outcomes of a random experiment is called the sample space associated with the experiment. So we denote it by symbol S. Now each element of the sample space is called a sample point. Simple terms. In other words, each outcome of the random experiment is also called the sample point. So sample space kya hua? Jitne bhi possible outcomes ho sakte hain, un sab ka set. And each outcome is a sample point. Each element of the set is sample point of the sample space. In random experiment, tossing of a fair coin, all possible outcomes, head or tail. So let's use the symbol H for head, symbol T for the tail. So sample spaces, two possible outcomes, set of all possible outcomes, head, tail. Let's say rolling of a fair dice, random experiment. All possible outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If you are interested in the number of dots on the upper face of the die, Ludo kheli thi humne. So sample space, set containing the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 1, 2, 3 symbolically, we are denoting the possible outcome. So NCRT example, dekhte kya diya hua hai. Two coins. A 1 rupee coin and a 2 rupee coins are tossed once. Find a sample space. So, two coin hai hamare paas, ek 1 rupee coin hai, ek 2 rupee coin hai. Humne unko ek bar toss kiya hai. So, clearly the coins are distinguishable in the sense that we can speak of the first coin and the second coin. So, two coin hai. Pehle ek ko ek first coin bol dete, dusre ko second bol dete hai. तो दोनों पे हेड या टेल आ सकते हैं. सिंस आइदर कॉइन कैन टर्न अप हेड और टेल, द पॉसिबल आउटकम्स मे बी हेड्स ऑन बोथ कॉइन, तो फर्स्ट पार्ट को फर्स्ट कॉइन पे एच, सेकेंड पे एच, एंड वी कैन राइट लाइक इन द ऑर्डर एच एच सिंबॉलिकली. सो हेड ऑन फर्स्ट कॉइन एंड टेल ऑन द अदर एच टी, टेल ऑन फर्स्ट, हेड ऑन सेकेंड टी एच, एंड टेल ऑन बोथ कॉइन्स सो टी टी. सो ऑल पॉसिबल आउटकम्स आर एच एच, एच टी, टी एच, टी टी. सैंपल स्पेसिस सेट कंटेनिंग ऑल पॉसिबल आउटकम ऑफ दिस रेंडम एक्सपेरिमेंट. लेट्स सी सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल. फाइंड द सैंपल स्पेस एसोसिएटेड विद द एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑफ रोलिंग ए पेयर ऑफ डाइस. दो डाइस हमारे पास, वन इज ब्लू एंड अदर इज रेड. वंस सो एक्सपेरिमेंट इज रोलिंग ए पेयर ऑफ डाइस, टू डिफरेंट डाइस, वन इज ए ब्लू अदर इज रेड. वंस तो सैंपल स्पेस पता करना है हमें इसको, एंड ऑल्सो फाइंड द नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स ऑफ दीज सैंपल स्पेस. सो सपोज वन अपीयर्स ऑन ब्लू डाई, देन टू ऑन द रेड डाई. वी नीड नॉट दिस आउटकम बाय द ऑर्डर्ड पेयर 1, 2. सिमिलरली इफ थ्री अपीयर्स ऑन द ब्लू डाई एंड फाइव ऑन द रेड, द आउटकम इज नोटेड बाय द ऑर्डर्ड पेयर 3, 5. तो फर्स्ट पे क्या आया और फिर उसके बाद सेकेंड पे क्या आया इन द ऑर्डर्ड पेयर. इन जनरल ईच आउटकम कैन बी डिनोटेड बाय द ऑर्डर्ड पेयर एक्स कॉमा वाई. Where x is the number appeared on the blue die and y is the number appeared on the red die. So therefore, the sample space can be written this form. Set S is the collection of all ordered pair x, y such that x is the number of the blue die and y is the number on the red die. Set builder form. So there are six choices for the x and there are six choices for the y. So number of elements in the sample space is 6 into 6. Multiplication rule of counting. And in tabular form, you can say all possible case outcomes are this. And there is a simple method which we use. Karte. So first pay 1, 1, 1, 1. So one first pay agar 1 aaya hai, to second pay kya kya possible hai. That's how you complete. 1, then second pair 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all the cases of 1 is complete, 1 on the first, and then we take the second case, 2 on the second, 2 on the first, and then all possible on the second, then third case, 3 on the first, and then all possible cases such that 3 is on the first coin, first die. So that's your sample space in the tabular form. Example 3. In each of the following experiments, specify appropriate sample space. So what is the experiment? In the one, a boy has a 1 rupee coin, a 2 rupee coin, and a 5 rupee coin in his pocket. So he has 3 coins, 1 rupee coin, 2 rupee coin, and 5 rupee coin. He takes out 2 coins out of his pocket, one after the other. So random experiment is, he takes out 2 coins out of his pocket and there are 3 different coins, one after the other. So let's start with this solution. So let symbolic, we will use the symbols. Q denotes 1 rupee coin, H for 2 rupee and R for the 5 rupee coin. So first coin, if he takes out, it may be any of the 3 coins, Q, H and R. But it can be 1 rupee, 2 rupee, 3 rupee. So corresponding to Q, means first coin is 1 rupee coin. The second draw can be either 2 rupee or 5 rupee. So H or R. So the result of 2 draws may be written like Q, H or Q, R. Similarly corresponding to N and similarly corresponding to R. So all possible outcomes comes out QH, QR, HQ, HR, RH, RQ. Complete? Clear? Okay. So what is the second question in this? A person is noting down the number of accidents along a busy highway during a year. number of accident. So that is the experiment. He is counting the number of accidents along a busy highway during a year. Ek saal mein kitne number of accident ho rahe hain. So what are the all possible outcomes? It can start from 0. It can be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, some positive integer. And 0 also. So sample space associated with this experiment is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are the number of accident. So sample space can have infinite number of sample points. The conditions are, it has more than one outcome and we cannot predict in advance. These are the two conditions. That's it. Now let's see the next example. So a coin is tossed. If it shows head, we draw a ball from a bag consisting of 3 blue and 4 white balls. If it shows tail, we throw a die. So what is the experiment? Ek coin ko hum toss karte hain. Head aaya to hum ek bag hai jisme 3 blue aur 4 white balls hain. Usme se ek ball draw karte hain. Aur agar tail aaya to we throw a die. Theek hai? So we have comprehended the question. Now let's describe the sample space of this experiment. So blue bags ke andar jo balls hain, let's denote them B1, B2, B3 and white balls symbolically W1, W2, W3, W4. Sample space kya banega? If it comes head, then we draw a ball. So it can be head ke baad blue 1, blue 2, blue 3, or white 1, white 2, white 3, white 4, if head is there. So symbolically we can write HB1, HB2, HB3, HW1 to HW4. Now if tail comes when you toss the coin, then we throw a die. So it can be T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, T6. So HB1 is clear. So what is on the first coin, head or tail? So we start with head, then we write next bag se kaun si ball aayi hai, all possible cases, and if it comes tail, then all possible cases of number on the die. Okay, so let's see next example. So consider the experiment in which a coin is tossed repeatedly until a head comes up. So what is the experiment? Ek coin ko hum repeatedly toss karte hain jab tak head nahi aa jata. Ek coin ke upar head ya tail aa sakta, right? So let's describe the sample space. Kya kya possible cases ho sakte hain? Coin ko toss kiya aapne, pehli baar mein head aa sakta, dusri baar mein aa sakta, pehli baar mein head na aaye, teesri baar mein aaye, pehli dono baar tail aaye, right? So in the experiment, head may come up for the first on the first toss, or on the second toss, or on the third, and so on till head is obtained. Hence the desired sample space is, first outcome can be H on the one first, then or tail on first and then head on second. So second bar jab toss aaya, toss mein aapka head aaya. So H, then TH or TTH. TTTH, 4 bar T, 4 bar toss kiya, tail aya, 5 bar head aya. So it can go up to infinity. So that's our sample space for the experiment. A coin is tossed repeatedly until a head comes up. Now let's describe, understand how the term event is described. Another term. So definition of event. Any subset of a sample space S. That's a mathematical definition. Exact and precise. So any subset E of a sample space S. Let's see the example. So consider a random experiment tossing of two coins. The associated sample space of this random experiment is headed, head-tail, tail-head, tail-tail. So that's the sample space. Now any subset of this is an event, is an event. Now in language, we say this event. So let's look at this. Now suppose that we are interested in those outcomes which correspond to the occurrence of exactly one head. So in language, we are saying we toss two coins and we are looking for occurrence of exactly one head. So corresponding to this event, outcome have, we find that HT and TH are the only elements of sample space S corresponding to the occurrence of exactly one head in the toss of two coins. So these two elements form the set E corresponding to event, event E, and this is a subset of sample space. So any subset E of a sample space S. So in this experiment, tossing of two coins, sample space, subset of that is this. And in language, this event is occurrence of exactly one head. The set E is the subset of the sample space, so this is an event. Each event, occurrence of exactly one head in language. So a random experiment tossing of two coins, exactly one head. We can define more events based on this experiment. Even HH, let's say this is an event subset of this set. Now this outcome HH is occurrence of exactly two head. Or in language, we can write it as occurrence of no tail. Event E2, occurrence of exactly two tails or occurrence of no head. So in language, it is important to comprehend that completely, which event is talked about. Let's look at this event, E3, subset of this. So we can write this. What are the outcomes? HT, TH, or TT. Occurrence of at least one tail. Or also we can write this, occurrence of at most one head. Zero head, one head, one head. Set E4 is the event. Occurrence of at least one head. HH, HT, TH outcomes. For this, in this set E4. Occurrence of at most one tail. Set E5. Oh, this is a sample space. Every set is a subset of itself. So occurrence of at most two head, we can write this. We can also write this occurrence of at most two tail. Set is E6, null set. So null set, let in the language we can say occurrence of more than two heads. Not possible in this experiment. So there is no outcome which is in the set E6 which causes occurrence of more than two heads. Null set is subset of every set. So number of outcomes in the set S are 4, N of S, that's the symbol we will use. We use for the set number of elements in a set. N of E2, N of E11, N of E21, N of E3, 3, N of E4, 3, N of E5, 4, N of E6, 0. Occurrence of an event. Definition. So the event E of a sample space S is said to have occurred if the outcome, let's say omega, of the experiment is such that omega belongs to set E. I'll read it again. The definition E of a sample space S is said to have occurred if the outcome omega of the experiment is such that omega belongs to E. कोई इवेंट E कब हुआ है? जब कोई आउटकम ओमेगा एक्सपेरिमेंट के ऑल पॉसिबल आउटकम में से ओमेगा एक्सपेरिमेंट आया है, एक्सपेरिमेंट का आउटकम, एंड दिस ओमेगा बिलोंग्स टू इवेंट ई सेट, देन वी से इवेंट ई अकर्ड. इफ द आउटकम ओमेगा इज सच दैट ओमेगा डज नॉट बिलोंग टू ई, वी से द इवेंट ई हैज नॉट अकर्ड. So in a random experiment, let's see the example, tossing of two coins, and that's a sample space. This event is the event occurrence of exactly two hits. Agar outcome aapka HH aaya, then which event occurred? Event E1 occurred. Occurrence of exactly two hits or occurrence of no hit. Similar to this. We just discussed this. Exactly two tails. Two tails. Occurrence of at least one tail or occurrence of at most one head, this event. Now, if you perform experiment tossing of two coins and outcome of experiment is HH, so let's say we are talking about these three events here, then if outcome is HH, event E1 occurs. If outcome is HH, then E2 does not occur, event E3 occurs. No, does not occur. Event E3 does not occur if the outcome is HH. Now let's go ahead. Types of events. So first event, impossible event. What is the definition? The event null set, empty set of a sample space is impossible event. In tossing of two coins, sample space. Let's talk about the event E6, occurrence of more than two heads. So in tossing of two coins, occurrence of more than two heads. Is this possible? No, it's impossible. No outcome, none of the outcome of the sample space ensures the occurrence of this event E6. E6 is null set. So this event E6 is impossible event. Any language, it's like we can see. If you toss two coins, दो से ज्यादा head नहीं आ सकता, right? But event we are talking about is दो से ज्यादा head आए, impossible event. Second, sure event. What is the definition? If the event S, the whole sample space. The event S of a sample space S is the sure event. So in this experiment, occurrence of at most two head is, that is the event E5. What is the E5 event? Is S. Each of the outcome of the sample space ensures the occurrence of this event. Which event? Occurrence of at most two head. So, in tossing of two coins, either outcome can be zero in language or one or two heads. Occurrence of either zero head or one head or two head. So, this implies that most two heads for sure occur in a toss of two coins. So, sure event. Third, simple or elementary events. Event. What is the definition? If an event has only one sample point of a sample space S. Only one sample point. Then we say event is simple or elementary event. So in a random experiment, tossing of two coins, occurrence of exactly two head, even, that's the possible outcome. Favorable outcome for occurrence of this event HH. So there is only one sample point. So number of elements in the event E1 is 1, simple event. In the event occurrence of exactly two tails, E2 is TT, set containing the element TT, N of E2 is 1, so simple event. Occurrence of at least one tail, let's talk about this event E3, three elements in this event, so not a simple event. So if the event has only one sample point, event is simple or elementary event. What is the result? This is the result. Remember, in a sample space containing n distinct elements, there are exactly n simple events. So this is important. Here I have written n distinct elements, not n possible earlier. All possible outcomes ki baat nahi kar rahe. If we have n distinct elements, then there are exactly n simple events. Fourth, compound event. What is the definition? If an event has more than one sample point of a sample space S, then we say event is compound event. Definition. So in the experiment tossing of two coins, occurrence of exactly two heads, that's the event E1. Number of elements in the event E1, 1. So not a compound event, it's a simple event. If the occurrence of at least one tail, event E3, number of elements in the set E3, event E3 are 3, so a compound event. Occurrence of at least one head, and of E4 is 3, so a compound event. If an event has more than one sample point of a sample space, the event is compound event. Occurrence of at most two head, E5, and of E5 is 4, so compound event. Algebra of events. Complementary event to an event. For every event E, there corresponds another event E dash called the complementary event to event E. It is also called event not E. So jo main bracket mein likh rahe na, isme likh rahe hain yahan pe. So we describe like what is that event. So event E is there, and then corresponding to that we have event E dash, which means not E. What is the definition? Given an element E and S be the sample space for a random experiment, the complement of E is the event consisting of all sample points that do not correspond to the occurrence of event E. That's a definition. So E dash, set E dash is S minus set E, which is in the set builder form, all omegas, set of omegas, and omega is such that omega belongs to S and omega does not belong to E. So in a random experiment, if we do the experiment tossing of two coins, that's associated sample S. So occurrence of exactly two heads is the event. So event E in the set form is this, occurrence of exactly two head. That's the favorable outcome for that, occurrence of this event. So event E dash, that is event not E, means event non-occurrence of exactly two heads. Exactly two head nahi ho rahe hain, aa rahe hain. So by the definition, set E dash is set S minus set E, which is set containing all elements of S which are not in E. So we exclude HH, we get this. So n of e dash is equal to n of s minus n of e. That's a simple result to remember. So we remember the definition exactly and result. Event E1 or E2. What is the definition? If E1 and E2 are two events associated with the same sample space, then the event E1 or E2 is same as the event E1 union E2 and contains all those elements which are either in E1 or E2 or in both. That's how we take the union of two sets. So definition of event E1 or E2. So E1 union E2 is set of all omega. Omega is such that omega belongs to E1 or omega belongs to E2. In other words, the outcomes favorable to occurrence of event E1 union E2 are the outcomes favorable to occurrence of event E1 or occurrence of E2 or occurrence of both. So this event E1 union E2 is occurrence of at least one of the events E1 and E2. E1 or E2 mein se at least ek to hogi hogi. That's the meaning of event E1 or E2, E1 union E2. Now let's describe event E1 and E3. What is the definition? So E1 and E2 are two events associated with the same sample space. Then the event E1 and E2 is the same as the event E1 intersection E2 and contains all those elements which are common to both E1 and E2. So E1 intersection E2 is set containing all omega. Omega is such that omega belongs to E1 and omega belongs to E2. In other words, the outcomes favorable to the occurrence of event E1 intersection E2 are the outcomes favorable to occurrence of both events E1 and E2. The event is occurrence of both events E1 and E2. That's the definition. So sometimes we also write event E1 E2. Event E1 but not E2. If E1 and E2 are two events associated with the same sample space, then the event E1 but not E2 is the same as the event E1 minus E2, E1 negation E2, and contains all those elements which are in E1 but not in E2. So in the set form, E1 minus E2 is the set containing all the omega. Omega is such that omega belongs to E1 and omega does not belong to E2. Keval wo elements hain jo E1 mein hain lekin E2 mein nahi hain. In other words, the outcomes favorable to the occurrence of event E1 minus E2 are the outcomes favorable to occurrence of event E1 but not to E2. The event E1 minus E2 is occurrence of E1 but not E2. Also, the outcomes favorable to the occurrence of event E1 minus E2 are the outcomes favorable to occurrence of event E1 and non-occurrence of E2. So all those outcomes which are favorable to occurrence of event E1 and non-occurrence of E2. Non-occurrence of E2 means E2 dash. So we can write E1 minus E2 is equal to E1 intersection E2 dash. And in the sets, if there is and, we take intersection. Okay. Let's understand them with the examples, inset examples. So what is given? Let's comprehend. Consider the experiment of rolling a die. That's our random experiment. Let A be the event getting a prime number. That's our event A. And B be the event getting an odd number. Write the set representing the events. Even or A or B, A and B, A but not B, not A. So what is the experiment? Rolling a die. So that's a sample space. Possible outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now event A is getting a prime number. So set containing the prime number out of first six natural numbers, which are 2, 3, 5. And B getting an odd number. So set B representing the event E, B is equal to this set containing odd numbers out of first six natural numbers, 1, 3, 5. Set from the set S. So we have event A, event B. Now we have, what we have to write? The set representing the event A or B. So event A or B is A union B, union of them. You got the answer? A and B means A intersection B, 3, 5. Event A but not B, A minus B, A, B. So only 2 is the element in A which is not in B. Not A means A dash, so S minus A. Simple. Clear? Now let's start with mutually exclusive events. What is the definition? So two events, E1 and E2 of a sample space S are mutually exclusive if the occurrence of any one of them excludes the occurrence of the other event. Exclusive word, humne suna na, exclusive. This belongs exclusively to this. The same way. Two events E1 and E2 of a sample space S are mutually exclusive if the occurrence of any one of them excludes the occurrence of the other event. So there is no outcome which favors both. So E1 intersection E2 is null set. E1 and E2 are disjoint sets. In other words, they cannot occur simultaneously. So no outcome favors the occurrence of both events E1 and E2 simultaneously. What are the results to remember? Simple events of a sample space are always mutually exclusive. Simple events, elementary events of a sample space are always mutually exclusive. A set of events is said to be mutually exclusive if occurrence of one of them precludes the occurrence of any of the remaining events. So if you have more than two events, we say they are mutually exclusive if occurrence of one of them precludes the occurrence of any of the remaining events. So no outcome, let's say if one outcome is there which favors the event E1. So that outcome does not favor any other event. So a set of events E1, E2, E3, up to EN, let's say, they are mutually exclusive if the events are pairwise disjoint. All of them. So mathematically, we can write EI, EJ, where I is from 1 to N and I is less than J. So if I take I is equal to 1, this is E1, J can be 2, 3, 4, 5 up to N. So E1 intersection E2, E1 intersection E3. So all those are covered for I equal to 1. If I take I equal to 2, then J will be 3, 4, 5, 6 up to N. So E2, E3, E2, E2, E4, E2, E5. So that's how we write if there are n events, e1, e2, e3, up to en, pairwise, all of them are covered in this notation, and intersection of them is null set. They are, all of them are disjoint sets. So pairwise, they are disjoint. So then we say a set of events is mutually exclusive. Let's see the example. So random experiment, tossing of two coin, that's a sample space. Occurrence of exactly two head, that's a event E1. Occurrence of exactly two tails, that's a event E2. Let's say event E3, occurrence of at least one tail, occurrence of at least one head, E4. E7, occurrence of exactly one head. So events E1 intersection E2, let's check E1 intersection E2, disjoint sets. So event E1 and E2 are mutually exclusive events. E1 intersection E3, E1 intersection E3, there's no common element, so null set, disjoint sets. Events E1 and E3 are mutually exclusive events. Let's check now E3, E2 and E3. Now their intersection TT is common. So events E2 intersection E3 gives us set containing the elements TT. So they are not disjoint sets. It's not a null set. So events E2 and E3 are not mutually exclusive events. Now if we talk about event E1, E2, E7. So event E1, E2, E7. Pairwise, E1 intersection E2, E1 intersection E7, E2 intersection E7. Null set, all three are null set. So set of events, E1, E2, E3 is mutually exclusive events. They are mutually exclusive events. Exhaustive events. What is the definition of exhaustive events? If E1, E2, E3 to EN are events defined on a sample space S, and we get E1 union E2 union E3 union to EN, so union of all the events is equal to sample space S, then these events are called as exhaustive events. That's the definition. And it means, so a set of events is said to be exhaustive if the performance of the experiment necessarily results in the occurrence of at least one of them. If you perform the experiment, then at least one of these events occur. Then we say the set of these events are exhaustive events. So if you're using the same example, tossing of two coins, let's say event E1 is occurrence of exactly two head, E2 is this, E3 is occurrence of at least one tail, occurrence of at least one head. These are four events. And we have taken event E7. So event union E3 gives us sample space. So E1, E3, they are exhaustive events. So any outcome, if you perform the experiment, any outcome come occur, then at least one of the event E1 and E3 occur. So set of events E1, E3 is exhaustive. If you take E1 union E2 union E3, we get this result, E1, E2, E3. That is equal to S. So set of events E1, E2, E3 is exhaustive. E1 union E4 union E7. Let's say we are talking about these three events. Now this is not equal to S. So set of events E1, E4, E7 is not exhaustive. If you look at this, if the outcome is TT, tail on both the coins, that none of the event E1, E4, E7 occur. So not exhaustive. If we take these four events, we get this sample space, which is equal to sample space. Huh? So set of events E1, E2, E3, E7 is exhaustive. Now let's look at the NCERT examples. What is given? Let's comprehend the question. Two dice are thrown and the sum of the numbers which come up on the dice is noted. Okay, so two dice ko humne throw kiya, two dice are thrown. और जो उनके ऊपर नंबर आया है हमने उनका सम किया और उसको नोट किया. ओके, नाउ लेट अस कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग इवेंट्स एसोसिएटेड विद द एक्सपेरिमेंट. सो कुछ इवेंट्स डिस्क्राइब किए. इवेंट ए द सम इज इवन. इवेंट बी द सम इज ए मल्टीपल ऑफ थ्री. इवेंट सी द सम इज लेस देन फोर. द सम इवेंट डी द सम इज ग्रेटर देन 11. व्हिच पेयर ऑफ दीज इवेंट्स आर म्यूचुअली एक्सक्लूसिव. So when we throw two dice, so there are 36 elements in the sample space, 36 possible outcome, 6 choices on one die, 6 choices on other die. So sample space is set containing all ordered pair x, y. X and y belong to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. X number on the first, y number on the second dice. Now the event A, the sum is even. So possible sums are 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So we look for the all the even cases. So for 2, 3, hame nahi chahiye, sum is even. So next is 4, 6, then 8, and रिवर्स स्पीड हमने चेक कर लिया. 4 के लिए, 6 के लिए, 8 के लिए, 6 के लिए, विद ऑल द पॉसिबल लाइक दे हैव व्हाट दे हैव लाइक स्टार्टेड. दे स्टार्टेड विद द व्हाट इज द लोवेस्ट नंबर ऑन द वन फर्स्ट कॉइन. 1 के साथ जो पॉसिबल केसेस है, देन 2 के साथ जो पॉसिबल केसेस है, 3 के साथ जो पॉसिबल केसेस है, 4 के साथ, राइट. सो दैट्स अ सम इवेंट ए. इवेंट बी द सम इज लेस देन 4. सो लेस देन 4 इट कैन बी 2 एंड 3. Sorry, the event B, the sum is a multiple of 3. So 3, 6, 9, 12. So all possible outcomes favorable to occurrence of event B. Event C, sum is less than 4. So possible is 2 and 3. And D, the sum is greater than 11, which is 12, possible case. Now, which are mutually exclusive. So if we look from this tabular form, A intersection B, null set, nahi hai. So they are not mutually exclusive events. And one more thing. Now let's look in the language. If we talk about the A and B, the sum is even and sum is a multiple of 3. So possible sum are 2 to 12. The sum is even, 2, 4, 6, 8, up to 12. And the sum is multiple of 3. So multiple of 3 and the sum is even, 6, 12. So there will be outcome which are favorable to occurrence of both A and B. So they are not mutually exclusive events. So similarly, you can check with A intersection C, A intersection D, B intersection C, B intersection D. In language, if we'll just check. So A and C, sum is even and sum is less than 4. They are not. Sum is even, 2 is sum outcome 2, which favors for the sum 2, 1, 1, which will, that will be same outcome favoring the even occurrence of event A and C. Right, we talk about A and D. Let's talk about A and D. Even, sum is even and sum is greater than 11. So 12 favors the both. So all the outcomes which favors the sum equal to 12, they will cause the occurrence of both events E and D. So they are not mutually exclusive. B and C, multiple of 3 and sum is less than 4, 3. So not X. They are not mutually exclusive. B and D, multiple of 3 and sum is greater than 4, 11. Clearly, 12 is the favorable outcome for both. So all the outcomes which favors the occurrence of sum equal to 12 will cause the occurrence of event B and D both. So they are not mutually exclusive, B and D. So these pairs are not mutually exclusive events. Now look at the C and D. So see, out of those four, A, B, C, D, how many pair were possible? So it's like that, no? Out of four, you have to select two. So 4C2 is 6. So we have checked this four and two are left. So which two are left? Left, C and D. And one more. Which one is left? AC, AD, BC, BD. So they have not checked for which one? AC, AB. AB. Achha, AB they have already checked. All right. So AB pair is not, AC is not there, AD, BC, BD. That's how we check actually. Kitne sare possible cases humare pas banne hai, kitne hume check karne hai. So four outcomes, well, four events ki baat kar rahe hai, A, B, C, D. And pair wise two. यानी कि चार में से दो हमको सिलेक्ट करने हैं जिनको हम लोग पेयर वाइज चेक करेंगे. सो विच इज लेफ्ट, सी एंड डी. नाउ सम इज लेस देन 4 एंड सम इज ग्रेटर देन 11, नॉट पॉसिबल, दे कैन नॉट अकर साइमल्टेनियसली. सो सी एंड डी आर म्यूचुअली एक्सक्लूसिव इवेंट्स. नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल, लेट्स कॉम्प्रिहेंड दैट. ए कॉइन इज टॉस्ड 3 टाइम्स, कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग इवेंट्स. सो कॉइन है हमारे पास, उसको हमने 3 टाइम्स टॉस किया है. इवेंट ए, नो हेड अपीयर्स. इवेंट बी, एग्जैक्टली 1 हेड अपीयर्स. सी, एग्जैक्टली 2 हेड्स अपीयर. सो दीज आर 3 इवेंट्स. डू दे फॉर्म अ सेट ऑफ म्यूचुअली एक्सक्लूसिव एंड एग्जॉस्टिव इवेंट्स? सो सैंपल स्पेसेस, कितने केसेस होंगे? 2 चॉइसेस ऑन फर्स्ट, 2 चॉइसेस ऑन सेकंड, 2 चॉइसेस ऑन थर्ड. 2 इनटू 2 इनटू 2, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, 8 possible outcomes. So, event A, no head appear. So that's event A. Exactly 1 head appear. Favorable for exactly 1 head. At least 2 head appears. 2 head. At least two, exactly two, and then exactly 3. So at least 2 head appear. So A union B union C is sample space S. In language, if you see, so 3 coins ko humne toss kiya hai. So number of head will be either 0, or 1, or 2, or 3. So if you look at the events A, B, C, all 4 cases are complete. At least one of them will occur. 0 head, event A, exactly 1 head. When even in event C, at least 2 head. So exactly 2 head is covered, and exactly 3 head is also covered. So mutually, they are exhaustive events. And in tabular form, you can check that. So A, B, C are exhaustive events. Now A intersection B, null set. Event A is no head. Event B, exactly 1 head. They cannot occur simultaneously. A and C, null set. No head appears, at least 2 head appear, cannot occur simultaneously. B intersection C, exactly 1 head, at least 2 head, they cannot occur simultaneously. And from the tabular form also you can check. So these events are pairwise disjoint. 3 events, 2 to 3C2. So possible cases you have to check is 3C2, which is 3. So yes, we did it completely. So they are mutually exclusive events. So A, B, C form a set of mutually exclusive and exhaustive events.